pure inspection regime. When those of you who are aware of Flagstones will be aware that the inspection regime imposed by the Flagstone is paramount. And it complies with the MOU for Paris, the Paris MOU, which is a quite listed state, and that is terribly important. The registration in Antigua, like many others, is multi-vessel. There's merchant ships, and they're developing into super yachts and ordinary yachts. I have a little boat in Antigua, and it was registered in Antigua, and yes, it had to be surveyed. It's a 25-foot motor boat, but before I could take up the Antiguan flag, it had to be surveyed, and it was, and it passed. Antigua's very closely linked with the IMO, as you would expect from a sizable flag registry. It conducts its own inspections. Yes, obviously, they have their own surveyors, but they use trusted and well-known surveying companies to assist. This is, was that 10 minutes or five? Sorry, he was waving fingers at me and I wasn't sure. And it has maintained its whiteness status. That may sound a bit glib, but I assure you, it isn't Antigua who says what status it has. It's the Paris MOU and IMO. And the bottom bit I put in because some ship owners will register their flags on the basis of how much it costs. That is sometimes not the best way. I've mentioned the fact that the UAE has diplomatic representation with Antigua. The Dubai-based representation I've mentioned. I think there is a need that UAE and Dubai in particular is linked to a white list flag registry. Next one. Recognised standards I've mentioned. The insurance issue is very important because any ship owner will go to his hull machinery or P&I club and must be able to demonstrate good whitelist capability to get the best premium. I did a little bit of work in one of the P&I clubs after I retired, and I will not name names, but there was one state, not too far from here, somewhere in the Indian Ocean, sort of, that was not even blacklisted, I think it was redlisted. It was just a complete no-no, and it didn't get insurance. That is the Antiguan flag. I say in use because that was the flag from my boat. But that is what it looks like. And I'm hoping that we'll see more of that flag on the stern of ships trading here in the UAE. Oh, a little plug there, sorry about that. That was meant for the Norfolk Institute talk I gave earlier in the week. There was a book collecting maritime evidence, and Jack, very kindly contributed to it, and it is for sale. If it's sold, not we, North Institute has sold over 6,000 copies, something that the RMS should think about. I think that's it. Yeah, that's an old photograph, by the way.
Thank you, Mark. Everything you say has immense value for me as well as others. Thanks, everyone.